An LVAD is a left ventricular assist device. That's a pump that supports the heart. Typically in the past, if we were trying to support a patient with congestive heart failure, we didn't have that many options. Only a small minority of patients can get transplant. It became apparent to us that there needed to be an intermediary step or another treatment to address these patients who were suffering with heart failure. Here at Stanford, Dr. Philip Oyer in 1984 implanted the first left ventricular assist device as a bridge to transplant. It's still a major surgery, just like a transplant, and you do have to open the chest and place this metal pump. But instead of replacing the heart with someone else's heart, you retain your own heart. The LVAD is there to support your heart and actually let it relax. The kinds of heart problems that an LVAD is fashioned for are essentially when the heart muscle is very weak. The question about whether patients would benefit who are currently on the transplant list in getting left ventricular assist device therapy is a very difficult one. We had always thought the best case scenario would be for our patients to get one surgery. Why put them through two surgeries, getting the left ventricular assist device and then transplant? Then we started seeing how good our outcomes were in terms of our patients who were waiting on the transplant list and got a left ventricular assist device and went on to transplant. Now we have patients coming to us who say, I have this left ventricular assist device therapy, my quality of life is so good, I'm not sure I want a transplant at this point in time. Or even in extreme cases, I want to be off the transplant list because I'm doing so well. In the year 2011, we did more left ventricular assist devices than transplants. What makes us feel good about this program is our patients and how they've responded to the therapy. I think that no one would be as happy as we are now with our program if our patients weren't doing so well. Our cardiologists were convinced when our patients started coming back to clinic after the LVAD was placed, and they told us, I wish I had this placed sooner. I feel so much better. Now, our longest running patient has been on the pump for 2 years. She has not been admitted to the hospital for more than 1.5 years, and her quality of life is quite good. Stanford feels privileged to be at the forefront of this technology. There have been great advancements in the field of left ventricular assist device therapy. What we hope over the next 10 to 15 years is that the technology will get to the point where patients won't even notice that they have an LVAD in place. But more importantly, I think, we'd like to see this technology become more durable. We also hope that these pumps will be smaller, because a smaller pump means a smaller dissection in the heart. And it hopefully means a quicker recovery.